here now. Somebody better get a shout on, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to hold. Somebody pray. Glory.
And mercy I've been shown. Oh, if you look into my eyes, you see life has tried to get the best of me. But I know the giver of life personally. He's the reason that I sing his name. He's made a way for me. If he hadn't loved me through the mistakes that I made, I just don't know where I would be. Oh, he showed me so much favor, and now I understand amazing grace. Through all of the pain, all of the shame, I realize there is nothing that could take your place.
Thank you.
Now, how many of you are saved in here? Some of your hand go up, right? And if I ask that same question, another question to that same person who hand went up and said, have you sinned since you've been saved? I believe everybody here go up. I'm going to ask it. How many of you in here saved? By the blood of Jesus, by believing that Jesus died and rose from again. The Bible says, if you believe that Jesus died and rose again, thou shalt be what?
Saved.
Saved. So how many of you believe that and are saved?
Lift your hand. I ain't saying nothing about falling on the floor, rolling under the seat. I ain't saying nothing about running around. I said, believe that Jesus died and rose again. The Bible said, you shall be what?
Saved.
There are more folks saved than what we give credit to.
Amen.
But the problem is how many will stay saved. A lot of them won't stay saved because they have no power to stay saved. They have not received the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Now, stay with me. I know this ain't what you want, but this is what you're getting.
Amen.
Caught up. We're talking about the rapture.
Amen.
The first resurrection. The first resurrection is just for me. So that means the second resurrection got to be for somebody else. Right? First, the dead in Christ shall rise first. That's the first resurrection. And the rest of the dead live not again until 1,000 years will expire. That's the sinner. After we get resurrected in the first resurrection, the sinner's going to still be in the grave for 1,000 years after we get caught up. I'm going on the first train.
Amen.
You heard that song say, I'm going home on the morning train. I'm going to get the first thing out of here. That's for me. That's my flight. I can't miss that one. Because if I miss that one, I'm messed up. Because the second time it coming for the sinners. Won't be no second chance. You being resurrected. Now I'm going to show you here. So now that we know that first resurrection, there are two. We are to be ready for the first one. I read in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 concerning what we call the rapture. The rapture is a word that means caught up or grown up or picked up or risen up. Amen. When Jesus come the first time, amen, he's coming for his church, coming for the saints of God, and the first resurrection. We shall be caught up to meet him with the other saints who have died in the air. Then the Bible says we shall be with him for 1,000 years reign. You remember the Bible said, he that suffer with him shall also what?
Reign
with him. We're going to be ruling with Christ after he set up his kingdom on this earth 1,000 years. We're going to help rule the world. God's going to show this world what it's like to have a righteous kingdom. And we are going to be part of reigning with him, ruling with him. Who are we going to be ruling? Those unsaved people, praise God, amen, that didn't give Christ their life during the 1,000 years. Those people that are still going to be here during the 1,000 years when the mark of the beast shall come. When people will not receive the mark, they have to be beheaded. They have to give their life in order to be saved. I have trouble giving my life up now with the Holy Ghost. Then to be here with the Holy Ghost out the earth, kind of give my life, amen, for Christ, when all of the food and everything will have to be received by a mark in your forehead. Now, this have not taken place, but as I speak, it is in the making. Amen. When you go to the counter now to buy your food, they just run it over that little thing. Drink, drink. Amen. That's a mark. In order to get food, you will have to take the mark of the beast. And the Bible said the mark of the beast was the mark of a man. 666 is his number. which means that it's a man authority, a man who is ruling, a man regulation, a man rules. Our government now is trying to become a one-word government. The superpower nation is trying to take over to be the one that ruled the whole world. United States against Russia and China, named the first forefront, the biggest nation in the world. That's why it's important they kind of make allies to become the biggest and the strongest in the power. But the one who is going to be the greatest is going to be Israel, according to the Bible, because they are God's chosen people. Now, this might not interest you, but people, it got something to do with you. The Bible said when you shall see armies surround Israel, know ye that the end is near. Now, we are living at the end of time. Amen, because the army, Russia, Afghanistan, and all of those people over there, they're trying to take over Israel. And the Bible already done predicted that when you see that happen, stand in holy places. When you started seeing wars and rumors of war and earthquakes and divers places, mothers and fathers and family breaking up, falling out with each other, know that the end is near. Father against sons and mothers against daughters. People, that's a sign. Those are signs that we're living in the last days. Yeah. Amen. Don't think it's strange when things start happening in your family. I never seen in a time that families are falling out with each other. Brothers and sisters can't even speak to each other. I'm talking about blood brothers and sisters. Same mama, same daddy. Refuse to get along. Father, son cursing out their father. Have no. And God want to help you. God can turn some things around for you. Don't take a chance with your life. Don't let nobody turn you from believing. Trust God and testify being saved. That's all the little preacher trying to tell you. That's all I'm trying to tell you. I ain't trying to trouble you, burden you. I ain't trying to bother you. I'm trying to help you. God will help you. God can do better than I can. Say it.
That's what we call
you. Oh, that's what we call you.
Major born, but on a tree.
You
died to save humanity.
Yes, sir.
You are the living word.
Jesus,
Jesus.
That's what they call him.
That's what we call you.
Your name is Jesus.
Major born, but on a tree.
Thank you.
You died to save humanity. You are the living word.
I believe your word. Thank you. Let us pray. This is your sinner prayer. This is your prayer of repentance. This is your opportunity to be saved. So, Lord, I'm a sinner. Forgive me of all of my sins. Make me your son or your daughter. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon my soul. Save me. I believe you died for me. And you rose for me. Help me to believe that I'm now free from this sin of bondage. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I pray this prayer. I believe this prayer. And according to your word, it is done. Now begin to thank him. Just like that. Don't let the devil say nothing else to you. Don't let the devil say nothing else to you. Just let them. Oh. call on that name. He washed you white as snow. Though your sin be red as crimson, he'll wash you, make you white as wool. You are delivered. Just like that. Don't.
Coming down your face.